atomwa akwanya ya paswa ile pile no mobile na ese ka kire mu ya mfanche nti paswa kwa yo mi ya ufa kire he ya ichina yo mu ye kama kama kana masi.
Again, happy Sabbath.
Happy day.
Me ba munyi na ho meda pa ebio.
In the last few weeks, I've been talking about this particular thing here, and I love it, so I want to discuss it in full with you as a church. All the Ghanaian ministers across Europe had a meeting about a fortnight or so ago, and I preached this sermon there. I see that it has had a very serious impact on me as a minister myself, so I think it's needful again for us to share
it together. Na someone who will say, oh, we say, and pass him me, a someone, or so, and then a sample man, so I was a question, so a check, it's a bit why I walk in Yamasu.
So, in the bulletin that you have in your hand, the sermon is captioned Boys Instead of Men.
I say, that a sima, a person, a big media, a young man, a young man, a young man, a over here, I say not sorry, or not as someone ever can. What you need to say? No, what's that? Kenya, you did when you were young.
Boys instead of men. Boys instead of men.
Ememua, na enye when you were.
That is what is in the bulletin. Boys instead of men.
I say no, and I walk right here, Simon.
However, the full sermon title is when God prefers to speak to boys instead of ladies.
Say, Oba Bemono, your person will become once a winning and say, when you go from pet, pass it, what it runs
when God prefers
say a bra
to speak to boys instead of ladies.
I say a bra when you go from a pet, I say, what name runs a cry of a cassa.
And when the ark appears to be useless, say nyamia pamdaka no abedam pain. Nem fasu bie muso ebra nyakupon so ni asafo painful bekasa no. Nemu no wanyesa ne mutafwa enekasa. But I was desperate.
My own pain.
Father divine, we plead with you over this moment. You will put me aside and talk to your holy ones. All of us, you are feeble, including myself. I plead with you, God, that you wash me. Just use me as a vessel, God, for you have been doing that aforetime. These holy people sitting here, those who are hearing my voice for the first time, those who are used to me, they rather long to hear your voice. Therefore, Master, speak for your servants. We hear and wait for you. We plead with you this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The scripture reading again is from 1 Samuel.
I can count Samuel on your nose. Samuel, who am I?
Chapter 3. The first four verses. First Samuel 3:1-4.
Samuel, can you tell me a sentence about the sin?
Now, the boy Samuel ministered to the Lord before Eli.
So now, before Samuel, so my Eli, and him.
And the word of the Lord was real in those days.
Now, Radi has some.
There was no widespread revelation. And it came to pass at a time while Eli was lying down in his place. And when his eyes had begun to grow so dim that he could not see.
And so none any every asiye kusu ahomu adiye.
And before the Lamb of God went out to the tabernacle of the Lord, where the ark of God was.
Now Yakupon Kanyano enya enu.
And while Samuel was lying down.
Now Samuel ada erade asore da enu.
That the Lord called Samuel.
Dia Yakupon adaka enu si enu.
And he answered, "Here I am."
Erade pray Samuel na osi biye.
Let me push this one forward. I need to change my spectacles. Okay. When God preferred to speak to boys instead of men, and when the ark of God appears to be useless,
we will
go to the background of the time of Samuel when he was called to be a prophet.
Say, if you hear someone, a problem with democracy, a prayer, why a woman want to be a prayer?
Looking into Samuel's before the Lord as a child, ministry as a child, and we look into who is a prophet and a prophetic gift, and look at Eli as a priest and draw lessons from his experience. Then we look into and discuss the importance of the lampstand and ark of God and God calling to Samuel. And our response.
Okay,
I brought it back. It's already there. So this slide epitomizes everything that we are about to talk about here at this moment. And please follow me. I might be moving a bit faster than my interpreter, so we're going to go fast because of time, right?
At the
time that we are reading from 1 Samuel, we will see that there were priests and there were elders in Israel, but God bypassed them and spoke to a young child. All the children in this church here at this moment, and as well as adults, I will kindly request you to follow me as we journey through this sermon. And when we were there, we were talking because it was the first time that my children have seen that cousin.
Israel was
and we had a corrupt priesthood.
now we only have to that castle, no, that's all.
And if you tell God to spread somewhere, you will see that the children of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were very ungodly.
Now, so can I pass on to say, not any of my dear mono? I can only have someone.
If you read from, I think, 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 26, let's go there. Now Eli was very old, and he heard everything from his sons did to Israel, and how they lay with the woman who assembled at the door of the tabernacle of meeting.
I say so now Eli about Akapra said, now what say Adia na the ma Adia Israel in Eina and Sedia, one and ma.
So he said to them,
now better on said,
why do you do such things?
I didn't think in a way, sir.
To hear of your evil dealings from all the people. Verse 24. No, my sons, for it is not good, it's not a good report that I hear from you.
Oh, that be my Matias and Papa and
you. You made the lost people transgress.
Mama, when you come, my eye upon it.
If a man sins against another, God will judge him.
Now, so Nipay upon it, Yanina Nipa, when you come, you will not take.
But if a man sins against the Lord,
now, so Nipay upon it, when you
come, who will intercede for him? Nevertheless, they did not heed the voice of your father. Because the Lord desired to kill them. And the child Samuel grew in stature and in favor both in the Lord and before men.
Now,
so
Samuel,
while the children of Eli, who were supposed to be pastors' children, while the children of his congregation, who were supposed to be taking their Bibles and be reading them,
they
had mingled themselves with the world. So spiritually, there was nothing good. But Samuel ministered before the Lord even as a child. Hello, children. Samuel ministered before the Lord even as a child.
When you are Samuel,
very young Samuel, when he started the ministry before the Lord, and his character is in contrast with the character of Eli's children who were old.
Was it?
Let's look at Samuel and the children of Eli, why we can understand why God will forget about the oldies and concentrate on the children.
Samuel
laid an atmosphere. When Samuel lived in an atmosphere which was pure and holy. Samuel would not go for clubbing in the night.
Samuel
will not come to church in the morning and in the night sneak out of the house and go and mess himself up over there in the community. Because God had told Israel and the children of Israel never to mingle themselves with outside over there. And Phinehas lived in an atmosphere of impious, self-seeking party. The child Samuel ministered before the Lord wearing a linen ephod.
Now I say, Samuel, what did it?
The linen ephod is the robe of the minister in those days. And before you will be a minister, as it's been said in 1 Samuel chapter 3, Verse 1, when the text says that Samuel ministered before the Lord, it implies that he was wearing a little effort.
And that
little effort was something that the priest would wear, not like this. The priest would wear over whatever they were wearing. And when you wear this effort, it contained two major things, the Urim and the Thummim, which was used for divination in those days. Therefore, if you are a 12-year-old guy and you avail yourself even as a child and you intend to minister for the Lord, I bet you God will give you the power to be able to make the world know much about you. The grown-up Hophni and Phinehas prostituted themselves in the holy work of the Lord by their own vile worldly order.
You see,
their ministry was very important. The children of Eli were supposed to have been doing the job that their father was doing, right? But when the children of Israel will bring their sacrifice, the meat, they are supposed to be prepared before the altar. But Hophni and Phinehas would go for their own portion, look at the meat which was nice, and they would select and eat them. And even the ladies who were coming to sacrifice would tell them, guys, will you kindly wait? And the Hophni and Phinehas
would be mad.
Some people in this congregation who may not necessarily be adults, or people who are already grown, while we are thinking of spiritual matters, they are fighting over meat. While we are thinking of spiritual matters, they are messing themselves up with the girls and the boys. While
you
are thinking of spiritual matters, they will ask themselves, even when is the pastor going to stop talking? And when spiritually we are thinking of spiritual matters, they will ask the pastor, Pastor, how long is your sermon? However, Samuel grew before the Lord, and the children of Israel grew outside the Lord and
disobeyed
God. The voice of God had become a tradition of the past. Go back to the text.
Chapter 3, verse 1.
Now, the boy Samuel ministered to the Lord before Eli. word of the Lord was real in those days. There was no widespread revelation. If I had come here to ask everybody here, how many of you read your Bible in the week? There will be trouble here. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Therefore, God could not reveal himself to the bigger guys. If I had a telescope that can penetrate all walls, and monitor your steps within a week, then the word of the Lord will be real in those days. And because of their spiritual laissez-faire, the text says that there was no open vision. Because the children of Israel were not concentrating on the things of the all of heaven, God could not reveal himself to him. The word of the Lord is the will of the Lord announced by the prophet, the seer, the man of God. The Bible says that in the beginning was the word, and the word was God, and the word was with God. But in those days, the word of the Lord was even rare among the Pharisees. By revealing his will through the prophet, God has offered to man the way by which he may restore to his original relationship. You know, in the Garden of Eden, man lost the power that God had given to him. Because we sold our identity. But God has laid a plan of redemption and tried everything possible to bring man back home. And the more that the Lord will try to restore man to his original relationship to himself, the more man would like to run away from the church. And even when they come to church and the pastor is preaching, they will be talking among themselves. In those days, the word of the Lord was real. However, the text says that his service was of the Lord. And so his service, Samuel's service, was unto the Lord.
Now Samuel,
and it was before Eli. That is, he learned from the work of the old man and obeyed to serve the Lord.
Now Swian, now Brandon,
I wish that we have a childlike religion. Like
someone.
You know, as a child, Samuel left his home and as did Moses. He left his home as Moses left
home.
But instead of being taken to the royal court of the pagan king, boy went to live with the priest in the sanctuary. Sometimes the youth, we say that we want to leave home and go to uni and live far away from home and do whatever that you want to do. That's not bad, I'm not talking against that. You know, I was in Coventry on Thursday. And I was speaking to one of the boys there. They said, Kofi, how is life here?
He said,
Pastor, I want to
come
back home.
I
said, Kofi, why?
I said,
I'm fed up cooking. My food, every food I cook is a mess.
I said, I want
to go back home and eat jollof rice for mommy. Then I look at him and say, Kofi, watch out. However, they were doing wonderful things. I saw Jason. Which one is Jason? Which one is the other one? Joel. I met Joel.
Joel
is the younger one. Jason.
Yes, Kumar.
So I met him and some of the youth now at the university. They have organized the whole program. They invited many people, and I was so proud of them all. And I met so many of our children across London in various churches that they were doing whole series, and I'm so proud. So, if you leave home, where do you go, Wachi? If you leave home, where do you go? Where do you go? You're established to be a prophet for the Lord.
So, obey Anna.
Surrounded by obvious corruption existing in those days. Samuel could not see. And listen to the text again. Verse 2. Because of time, it will rush and finish it up. Verse 2. And came to pass at the time while Eli was laying down in his own place, and when his eyes had begun to grow so deep that he could not see.
As in a brave woman, I must say, the beer, Eli da, ne da breno, and so none of me every, I say, I was kusu, I won't adhere
you. You see, sometimes the pastor Quartel of Force and the Jones and the big guys in the church cannot see.
Bet me every beer, and that's a brave beer, so poor, and then a part four, never be possible, I want to be one year.
Hello? And that is very true.
I am a prepper on you.
The eye of Eli was growing what? Even when they are in the church and the children are talking, they cannot see. Even when things are going haphazardly, they cannot see. Eli is sleeping. Old pa was snoring. I've got a nephew in Bracken. And he came to my house, and when he went home, his father called me. And the little boy, not knowing that I was on the other end of the phone, then he said, Brian, how does Pastor Uncle do? What does he do? But you cannot be like him. He said, yeah, I can. Okay, be like him, let me see. Not knowing that when he came out of my
body.
And he took it over him. He went to lie on the bed and said, I am uncle. Eli is sleeping in that he cannot see. Eli the priest was a kindly good man, but wanting in firmness. This particular prophet, Prophet Eli, he was a good man. But he was wanting, he was less of firmness. And was consenting to evil partly perhaps from lack of moral courage and
We
should be able to call the spade a spade as leaders of the congregation of God. Let your nay be nay and your yea be yea in the presence of God because you are the leaders. And Eli was sleeping. He is not charged with the force of his own administration of the offense, but with the sins of the children. My elders, my board members, my leaders of this congregation, sometimes God is going to blame you not because of the sins that you have done, but because you were negligent of whatever others were doing in the house. You don't have to neglect the plain duty of restraining and correcting the children of this church. We have to lead them into the path of righteousness for the sake of the Lord. And as a mother and as a father, you too, you are a priest. And you have said today that you do everything to raise up the children before the Lord. Don't sleep or walk out in Bono, you follow sleep.
Now, what's the point? And then, I said, but then we better to know how the number is ready.
It is not only work. We have to train up the children the way that they should go.
I was saying to you, ma.
When the priests are faithless and people are careless, God's voice will often sound from a lonely child like this. We should have enough time. Verse 3. Somebody read verse 3 for me.
Verse 3. Now, when you go to the end of the day, now Samuel, at the end of the day, I'm sorry,
Okay. Did you hear that?
What is that?
And before the Lamb of God went out the tabernacle of the Lord, where the ark of God was, and Samuel, you see, the light had not gone off yet. Are you following me, church here? And you're correct, it's the meaning. That is the meaning.
If it is not good, then.
Even though things were going haphazardly, there was still light. So the light of the Lord was still shining. You see, this is the good news. In those days, I wish I had enough time. Please give me 5 minutes, let me finish this. In those days when the priest was going to sleep, they would light the candle, the 7 candlesticks, and the candlestick will be there until morning. In the morning, the light will be off. So because the text says that the candlestick was still there, it implies that it was around dawn. And Eli was sleeping. Literally, he was supposed to sleep because at least he was an old man. Are you following me here? And while it is still dawn, the light of the Lord is still burning. Even though the word of the Lord was real in those days, even though spiritually the children of Israel were down there, but church, the candle is still burning. Stand up, let us pray. Stand up, everybody, stand up. Wherever the world has taken you to,
so far as we are still alive, God's grace is abundant.
So, perhaps you are saying they will call me.
Even if we are in
difficult, don't put you now, do you say,
you are falling apart.
The light is still dark. And the light has not gone off yet. The Savior will come. And now that it's still dark, where there is spiritual apostasy, when nations are fighting against nations, and when we don't even know where the United Kingdom is going to land, God's light is still shining. Something very important. Don't be lukewarm. We should not lose our spiritual value and our spiritual vision. We should not be degenerated. Oh God, lukewarmness, the Lord will detest it. Therefore, in Revelation chapter 3, verse 18. I counsel you to buy from me gold refined, that you may be rich, and white garments, that you may be clothed, that the shame of your nakedness may not be revealed, and anoint your eyes with eye salt, that you may see. Anoint your eyes with eye salve that you may see. The eye salve represents spiritual vision. I'm so happy that the light is still shining in your life. Something that has eluded in early during those times will never be deleted from you. We cannot afford to lose our spiritual vision in this darkest period of earth history.
Christ
invites you to come to him, to anoint your eyes, anoint your eyes out, so you can see visions of truth. That he has for these people of his last days. We have to keep the light burning.
said,
so an ark of God will appear to the useless. There's no time to finish the sermon by the end of the day. You've known that if you come to Him, He will accept you. Even though you deviated from His presence, the light is still burning. Whatever thing that you've messed yourself up with, the light is still there. This afternoon, we're going to pray over this sermon that the light of God will shine.
When
the Lord invites you, that where are you
fighting?
You can see Him. That's why we call Samuel. And before the Lamb of God went up in the tabernacle of the Lord, when the ark of God was in, while Samuel was still lying down, that the Lord called him and answered, "Yeah, I pray that you too can say,
yeah."
Those who came to visit us, I'm telling you today that God too is calling you. And will you respond to tell the Lord, "Lord, here"? You don't have to be old in the church or new in the church. You may be as young as Samuel, 12 years old spiritually, but when He calls, will you say,
"Hey"?
Oh God, Father Divine, oh you righteous one, oh you holy one. Eli was sleeping. Please wake us up. Help us to think of spiritual things, oh God. Help us to avail ourselves to you, oh God. You are a wonderful God. We know that you love us. That's why you died to save us. Today you are calling us to come home. Wherever that we've been, oh God, you are inviting us to come home. We are standing telling you, Lord, we are willing to come home. Wash us, clean us, and make us new. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Be seated. May God bless you.
I trust you won't travel.
Amen.
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 We give thanks to God for speaking to us.